Okay, so now we're going to take a quick detour from what we were doing because I really want to discuss a trick that can be very useful when solving some problems. So this trick is going to be useful whenever you encounter a potential that is even. Okay, in fact, the example that we'll see in the next video will be much easier, it will be solved much easier if you use this trick. Okay, so what is this trick? So what this says and what we're going to show is that if we have an even potential, remember, what does this mean? Even just means that if we have some potential that depends on x, then v of minus x is going to be the same as v of x. That is just what even means, right? So what this says is that if we have a potential that is even, then we can take the solutions as the sum of even and odd solutions, right? Because remember, the most general solution is always going to be just the sum of all of the possible solutions, the linear combination. Okay, so that is what we're going to prove now. So how do we do that? So let's just take a look at our Schrödinger equation, right? So second derivative psi of x. This time I will be writing this x dependence because it's important to know if it's f x or minus x or whatever. So then we have this potential psi of x equals e times psi of x. So this is our solution, and this is our equation. And for this equation, psi of x is a solution. What is psi of x? We don't know, but we know that that is the solution. So let us now take this equation, but instead of x, put minus x in here and see what happens to this equation. So when we do that, we're going to, these constants will obviously remain the same, the derivative 2, and now this time dependence will be minus x plus the potential of minus x psi of minus x equal e psi of minus x. So this kind of looks like the Schrödinger equation. Remember, this right there is the Schrödinger equation, but this time we have this potential of minus x. But in this particular case, the potential is even. So this right here is the same as just the potential of x. And when we use that, we can see that this is exactly the same as the Schrödinger equation, but this time the solution is not psi of x, but psi of minus x. So what this means is that if our potential is even, then not only is some function psi of x going to be a valid solution, but also psi of minus x. So what we can do then is build the most general solution by adding, or more correctly, by just taking a linear combination of these two. So let's just say, okay, what happens if we add these two? So let's just add them. So we get psi of x plus psi of minus x. So this is one possible solution to the Schrödinger equation. So, and let us see what happens to this. So this is going to depend on x. So let me emphasize that. This is just going to be psi plus of x. So let us now see what happens if instead of x, we take minus x. So in that case, we get psi plus of minus x. This is going to be equal to psi of minus x plus psi of minus minus x, but minus minus cancels out. This is just psi of x. And now we can see these two things are the same. So what this means is that psi plus of minus x is just going to be the same as psi plus of x, right? So this then means that psi plus of x is even. So we see that since this potential is even, we can then find, we can see that this problem, whatever it is, we haven't discussed what the potential is. The only property that we are discussing is that it is even. If it is even, then we know that we can find solutions that are even. And let us see now what happens if instead of adding these, we subtract them. So let us take psi minus. I call them minus and plus because we're adding and subtracting. You can call them whatever you want, it doesn't really matter, but it's always good when you give things names that help you remember what they mean. So this is just going to be psi of x minus psi of minus x. So similarly as before, let's just let x go to minus x and see how this function behaves. So this is going to be psi minus of minus x. This will be psi of minus x minus psi of minus minus x, but as we know, that's just x. So here we can factor out a minus sign, and we can see this is going to be minus psi of x minus psi of minus x. But this is just what we started with. So that's just minus psi minus of x. So we can see that psi minus of x is an odd function. So why did we do this? Because as we saw, when the potential is even, we can see, and we just proved, that solutions that are even and odd exist. So what we can do is write the most general solution that we are now just going to call psi of x as this linear combination of psi plus of x plus psi minus of x, right? Which is basically the sum of the even and the odd solutions. Now, this might not seem very useful if you're seeing this just now, but we will use it in the next example, in the next two videos, in fact, because this is really, really useful in quite a few situations. So in the next video, we will be discussing an example, but not using this trick. And then I will make another video with the same example, but using this trick, so that you can see why this is so useful. So just to go through this again, what we just showed is that if we have an even potential, we can take the solutions to be the sum of even and odd solutions. Okay, that's what we just proved. And well, that's what I wanted to do in this video. So I will see you in the next one.